fight against COVID-19, which took everybody by surprise. No doubt, the entire world was not prepared for what came from us. Even the advanced technological countries seem to be struggling to contain it. As an organization, our response was critically based on ensuring that our business continues, so we have a crisis management system for us. And of course, we are part of the larger society. We also understand that we end up having cases as it were. So we also have a case management team that also needs to do that. And it was in the course of the deliberations of these two bodies that we ended up, what are the challenges really facing the battle against COVID-19? And came to understand that testing is a key part of that battle. And we started rather late testing. Our capacity to test was also very limited when people that have gradually improved. So it was in response to strengthen that aspect of the war against COVID-19 that the management of Stanbic took a decision to bring in test kits, the PCR test kits, which was the standard WHO test kit for COVID-19. It's a lot of delay to be able to prepare these test kits to Nigeria.
Now, beyond that, we've been doing quite a number of things. Part of it is our drive through that is at Point Zero. It is helping to test people for free in Lagos State. Supported by people like you. I mean, this is an example. Some people gave funds, some people gave PPE, some people gave test kits, some people gave RNA kits. And we've been keeping that place going. With funds from international and corporate organizations like Stanbic. Not for you people, that place would have closed down. But we don't have special subvention to keep that going. So we're very happy for this help. We've also been involved in developing some local kits. I mean, right now, this is a test kit, it's not an RNA kit. We've developed an RNA extraction kit. Currently, we are developing a test kit like this that will be used beyond laboratory, that people can take it around. Now, even in your clinic in Stanbic, you can get one from us. All you need to do is ensure a close up with PPE so that it's not a source for transmitting virus to others. So with this kind of help, we'll be encouraged to do a lot more. And that is the way to move the health system and research forward. I think COVID-19 has not just been a bad story for the world. I think the success story in it is that it woke us up to realize the weakness of our health system. Even where we thought they were strong. When they are out of it, they will be able to plan them. More importantly is that all kinds of ingenuity are coming out, even from Africa, where people think that we cannot make significant contribution to science. We are now developing things in-house, locally. For me, the one that is most important is that it created awareness among private organizations, the need to support research, and the need to support the health system, knowing the fact that government alone cannot do it. We've been trying to get some corporate organizations to join us and fund our activities at the Nimr Research Foundation. It wasn't easy. But since Corona came, voluntarily, people are bringing money, they are bringing material, they are bringing. So it occurred to them that this is necessary. And therefore, post-COVID, like they say, the new normal, they will now realize that, oh, indeed, we should support research. We will not need to spend so much energy to talk to Stanbic, for example, that, oh, we want to do research. In this period has made them realize that. And they themselves have given, so it's not the first time. They are not going to be saying, oh, so how do we do that? We haven't done it before. This is the advantage in this happening. And I think the whole world should realize that. And don't see just the bad in Corona, the fact that it kills people alone, but the fact that it also woke the society up. And some of us now take on new responsibility to support our system. So finally, I would like to thank Stanbic through you for this kind gesture once again. To say that this should be the beginning of future long-term collaboration between Stanbic and Nigerian Sovereign Research. We will continue to reach out to you, and I'm sure within your capacity you also continue to do it. Please give our regards to the MD and the entire staff. We are very appreciative of this. Unfortunately, we cannot shake, so we can do this for the